Hey folks, how you doing? Captain Mark here, incentivefishing.com. All right, today's episode, Simply Simrad extension lines. What are they and how are they going to help me catch fish? Well, let me show you, all right? I'm going to use this can right behind me. See, how you doing? We're going to use that as an example, all right? We're going to use that, we're going to go mark it, we're going to pretend it's structure on the ground, and how we're going to get on that structure with extension lines, all right? So stay tuned, shake these, we'll see what happens, all right? Extension lines. They're going to help you catch fish. Extension lines. How do we find them on the Simrad NSS9 Evo 2, 12, 16, whatever you got, a 7, doesn't make a difference. Let's go show you how to do that, all right? So what we're going to do here is go into the Pages button. All right, we're in the Settings. Hit Settings. We're going to the Chart. We're going to hit Extension Lines right there, all right? Now, Extension, it gives you the options of either going course over ground or heading. A heading is basically which way, direction your boat's facing. Not very important when it comes to drifting, because you want to know where your boat is going, and that's called COG, which is course over ground. We're going to click that one and we're going to save it. All right, so what that does now is you're going to see when we go back to chart, you're going to have this little fugazi thing right there. It's called an extension line. All right, so the extension line now, my boat now is drifting away from that piece, which we call number of the test, right? The test is drifting away from it. So what I want to do is I want to be able to put this within the extension line to know that I hit it properly. So I have to go move my boat now to get it into position. So this is, again, drifting, isolated structure. This is perfect if you're a shark fisherman, if you're a bass fisherman, even fluke, if you have to hit a precise piece, precise rock pile, it's just the area where you really want to get through. The extension lines are going to help you. As you notice now, my heading is straight up, and the course over ground extension line is going obviously the direction my boat is going. So it's going to change when you're making way. Making way means you're under power, you're moving. And it's going to always go where the boat's going. So my course over ground obviously is here. All right, you can change all this stuff. I'm not going to deal with that right now, the menu. But I'm going to put myself over, and I want to be able to drift this X. I want this extension line to hit this properly. This way you can tell your clients where the heck you are, when to drop, what's happening. So let me stop that boat, and you're going to see now this extension line is going to start working its way back down current. And now I'm going to stop this boat from drifting, just stop it from making way. And now watch the extension line. The extension line is going to tell you where this boat is going to go. Here's our target here, okay? I'm going to show you how you can make those extension lines. I'm going to miss this big time. So I'm going to readjust now. I'm going to wait for this boat, because I just turned the boat. I'm going to wait for this boat to make its move, and then it's going to tell me where this thing's going to be going. So I'm not really drifting yet. I'm starting to drift naturally, and there it is. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to readjust my boat now over here so that extension line hits it. So I'm going to do that now. So now I'm doing it. I'm literally going to crash into this buoy. I'm literally going to crash into this thing. So I got to bail out. That's me going into that structure. See how accurate it is? All right, folks. Now, how are extension lines going to apply to shark fishing? It's a great question. I'm glad you asked it.
Nobody said a thing.
No, I thought I heard somebody ask.
You're delusional.
Whatever. All right. How does it apply? How do we do that? We're going to be covering miles of water. And it's easy. We're going to go into Settings, we're going to go back into Chart, we're going to go into Extension Lines, and we're going to get out of the 2-minute one, and we're going to go into Infinite, okay? Infinite now will show that extension line all the way to the outside of the as far as that you pan out on that GPS and that chart, the extension line will go there. So that's where it comes into play with shark fishing. You can see a long distance, you can put that thing out miles, you can pan out miles and see it's going to go through your drop offs or your wreck, wherever you're going to do that, okay? Take into consideration, though, environmental issues with it. If you are out shark fishing and you have a steady 5-knot wind out there and you got the current going whichever way you want to be, know that that will be a true extension line. Your drift will be true. if you start the extension line and the wind picks up to 20 knots,
what?
And you think you're on line, obviously that's going to blow you off of your drift that you anticipate to be on that wreck. So take that into consideration. Extension lines have their place in the fishing world, but they're a cool place, all right? So sometimes you'll be sitting out there and say, hey, this is a perfect opportunity for me to use extension lines to get onto structure, all right? That's all I'm saying. Use it, play with it, see if you like it. If you like it, thumbs up. If you don't like it, don't worry about it. People ask me, hey, I don't have a Simrad. How can I get this stuff too? I just go on your machine. It's very simple to fix this thing when you want to fish extension lines. You just go into your settings, hit waypoints, scroll down, go to one that says home on it, hit the one that says home, go right back to your house, put your boat on the cleats, get on your buddy's boat who has a Simrad and go out there and get some fish, all right? All right, thanks for watching Kid Cochise Outdoors. If you dig it, like it. If you don't dig it, don't dislike it. That's very mean to do, all right? So subscribe, tell your friends to subscribe, and share these. Thanks, everybody, for the emails, and be sure that there's more stuff coming out for the Simrad stuff, and there's more stuff coming out for KIDCOCHIESE Outdoors. The Simrad stuff, the questions you guys asked, I will try to address them. And if not, go to Simrad.com, go to SimradYachting.com, and go to see Mikey Smeds on Team Old School, all right? I'm Captain Mark.